Hello dear students, I am Jay Kishan. Welcome to the 9th part of chapter 8 quadrilaterals. Students, in the last part we have completed till exercise 8.1 and today we are going to start the new topic, and that topic is the midpoint theorem. So students, what we will cover in the lecture of today, we will cover the midpoint theorem, converse of midpoint theorem and concepts of interception. Okay, so these three topics we will cover today. So let us start our first topic, and the topic is the midpoint theorem. Okay, so what is the statement of this midpoint theorem? Statement is, the line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle is parallel to the third side and equal to half of it. So what is the meaning of this statement, students? Suppose there is a triangle ABC. Okay, suppose this is the triangle ABC. Okay, and D is the midpoint of the side AB and E is the midpoint of the side AC. So if we join this B to E, if we join this DE, then this side is parallel to the third side and its length will be equal to half of it. Okay, so this is the statement of the midpoint theorem, that if we join two midpoints of the two sides of the triangles, then the side which is formed, it should be parallel to the third side and equal to half of it. Okay, so this is the concept. Means what here, this, what is the meaning of the statement here? Okay, its meaning is that if we join, if D is the midpoint of the side AB, E is the midpoint of the side AC, and if we join DE, then this DE will be parallel to the third side, means this side. Okay, and the length of this DE, it should be equal to half of the BC, means it will be half of this BC. Okay, so this is the statement of this midpoint theorem, and it is very important from the examination point of view. So today we'll prove it, that how we can say that DE is parallel to BC and its length is equal to half of the third side, that is BC. Okay, so firstly we will write that what is given to prove this theorem. Firstly we will write that what is given here. So it is given that a triangle ABC, in which a triangle ABC in which D is the midpoint of AB and E is the midpoint of AC. Okay, so it is given that there is a triangle ABC in which D is the midpoint of this side AB and E is the midpoint of this side AC. Okay, so here what is to prove? What is to prove? We have to prove that this DE is parallel to the third side BC and the length of this DE is equal to half of the third side, that is BC. Okay, so this is to prove that DE is parallel to BC and DE is equal to half of BC. Now students, to prove this theorem, okay, we have to do some construction here. Okay, what construction we will do? What construction we will do here? Through C, we draw a line such that the line should be parallel to this AB. Okay, means what I am saying, that through C, we draw a line, suppose this line we have drawn. Okay, and such that this line AB and this line, suppose am extending it here, okay, like this F, okay. So we have drawn this CF such that it should be parallel to this AB, okay. So here in the construction we will write that through C draw a line CF such that AB is parallel to CF, means this line AB and this line CF should be parallel. So here I have done the construction such that the line AB and the line CF is now parallel, okay. Now coming to the proof part, students, how we will prove it, let us see. See, students, here if E is the midpoint of this side AC, then it is clear that the length of AE, it should be equal to the length of EC, because E is the midpoint. E is the midpoint means the length of AE, it should be equal to the length of EC, okay. And here D is the midpoint of this side AB, means this side and this side should be equal, okay. So here in the proof part, we will see in these two triangles, in triangle AED and CEF. In these two triangles, students, you can see the angle this and the angle this, okay. These two angles are equal to each other. Why? The reason is vertically opposite angles, okay. And then this side is equal to this side because E is the midpoint of this side, okay. And this angle, suppose the name of this angle is 1, this angle is 2, this angle is 3, and this angle is 4, okay. So here angle 3 will be equal to angle 4. Why? What is the reason behind it? Because we have drawn these two lines, we have drawn this CF such that it should be parallel to AB. So if it is parallel to AB, then AC will be the transversal, and if AC will be the transversal, then angle 4 and angle 3 will be alternate interior angles. So here, because of the reason angle side angle, we can say that these two triangles are congruent to each other, okay. So firstly we will prove that these two triangles are congruent, and how we will prove it? By angle side angle, okay. Angle, the first one is angle 2 is equal to angle 1, and the reason behind it is vertically opposite angles, okay. And then side means the side AE is equal to the side AC, okay, or you can say CE, and the reason is E is midpoint. Since E is the midpoint of AC, that is why this AE and CE are equal. And then the last one, that is angle 4 is equal to angle 3. The reason is what? The reason is AB is parallel to CF. AB is parallel to CF and they are alternate interior angles. Okay. So here we can write that by angle side angle, triangle AED is congruent to triangle CEF. Okay, students. So here we have proved by the criteria angle side angle that these two triangles are congruent. Okay, so these two triangles are congruent. Now, students, if these two triangles are congruent, then by CPCT, we can say that the length of DE will be equal to the length of EF because they are the corresponding parts of the triangle. So we can say that DE is equal to EF. Okay, what else we can say? We can say that the length of CF is equal to the length of AD. We can say that the length of CF is equal to the length of AD. See, you can see that if these two triangles are congruent, okay, if these two triangles are congruent, then their corresponding parts AD, it should be equal to CF. Okay, so here we have written that DE is equal to EF and CF is equal to AD. But we know that, students, we know that AD is equal to DB. Okay, why? Because D is the midpoint of this side AB. So if D is the midpoint of this side AB, means AD and DB should be equal. But here what I said, here I have said that this AD is equal to CF. So if AD is equal to DB or AD is equal to CF, it means that from above we can say that DB is equal to CF. DB is equal to CF. Okay, means this side is equal to this side. Okay, this DB is now becoming equal to CF. And here in the construction, I have said that AB is parallel to CF, means this whole side is parallel to CF. And so if the whole side is parallel to CF, so we can say that the part of this side is also parallel to CF. Means we can also say that DB is parallel to CF. So students, from these two, what conclusion you can extract here? You can say that, see, this DBCF is a quadrilateral. Okay, this DBCF is what? It is a quadrilateral. And you know that if in a quadrilateral, one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel, then that quadrilateral is what? That quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So here also, you can see that if this DBCF, in this DBCF, if the side DB is parallel to CF and the side DB is equal to CF, then you can say that quadrilateral DBCF is a parallelogram. And if this quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then it is obvious that the side BC, then this will imply that the side BC is parallel to the side DF. Earlier we have proved that this quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So if this quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then its opposite sides are parallel and equal. Means this BC will be parallel to this DF, as well as this BC should be equal to DF. Now students, if I am saying that this BC is parallel to DF, then if BC is parallel to the whole side, then it will be parallel to the part of this side also. Means in the next line we can say that BC is parallel to DE. Okay, and here BC is equal to DF. So we can say that BC is equal to DF is what? DF is the sum of DE and EF. The sum of DE and EF. Okay? The sum of DE and EF. Here, students, you can see that I have shown that DE is equal to EF. So if DE is equal to EF, means at the place of EF, we can put DE. Okay? At the place of EF, we can put DE. So here what is coming, that 2DE is equal to BC. So what you can prove from here, that DE is equal to, this 2 will be shifted, and if it will be shifted, then it will be equal to half of BC. Okay, so this is the part that we have to prove, that this BC is parallel to DE and this DE is equal to half of BC. See, we have to prove that DE is parallel to BC. Okay, so we can write here either DE is parallel to BC or BC is parallel to DE. Both are same. And the next one is what? DE is equal to half of BC. So here DE is equal to half of BC. So this we have shown. Okay, so students, this is the proof of the midpoint theorem. Okay, once again I am telling you that what I have done here. Let us try to understand one more time. Okay, see students, what was given? It was given that there is a triangle ABC and D is the midpoint of this side AB and E is the midpoint of the side AC. Okay, so if we join this DE, then this side DE is parallel to BC. We have to prove that if we join this DE, then this DE should be parallel to BC and its length should be equal to half of it. Okay, this was to prove. What I have done through C, okay, through C, I have drawn a line, and that line such that, okay, through C, I have drawn a line such that this line should be parallel to this AB. Okay, so I have drawn a line such that it should be parallel to AB, and after that I have extended this DE. Suppose it intersect at point F. Okay, after that, in these two triangles, firstly what I have done, firstly we have to show that these two triangles are congruent. Okay, how we can show that these two triangles are congruent? For that we have suppose it is angle 1, it is angle 2, okay, and this is angle 3 and this is angle 4. So angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Reason is what? Reason is vertically opposite angles. After that, this side AE is equal to the side EC. Why? Because of E, because it is given that E is the midpoint of this side AC. So that is why this side AE and EC are equal. And then angle 3 is equal to angle 4. The reason is what? The reason is by construction. Okay, by construction, CF is parallel to AB. And if these two sides are parallel, then their alternate interior angles should be equal. So because of that, angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Now, by angle side angle, we have shown that these two triangles are congruent. Okay. So if these two triangles are congruent, then by CPCT we can say that this DE is equal to EF. Okay. We can say here that this DE is equal to EF. What else we can say? We can say that CF is equal to AD. If we have shown that these two triangles are congruent, then this side also, it should be equal to AD. Okay? So here I have written that CF is equal to AD. Now, if CF is equal to AD, and we know that AD is equal to DB, because D is what? D is the midpoint of this AB. Okay? So AD is equal to DB. So here AD is equal to DB and here AD is equal to CF. Means what? From these two we can say that this DB is equal to CF. Why? Because AD is equal to DB and AD is equal to CF. So things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Okay? So DB is equal to CF. Okay? So now students, here we have seen that in construction that AB is parallel to CF. So if AB is parallel to CF, we can say that DB is also parallel to CF. Okay, so here DB is parallel to CF. Okay, so if DB is equal to CF and DB is parallel to CF, so we can see here in this quadrilateral that in quadrilateral DBCF, one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel, then that quadrilateral will be what? We have studied in the properties of parallelogram that if in a quadrilateral one pair of opposite sides are parallel and equal, then that quadrilateral will be what? That quadrilateral will be a parallelogram. So here we can say that then DBCF is a parallelogram. So if this quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then the other pair of this parallelogram, other pair of opposite sides of this parallelogram is also parallel and equal. Okay, means this BC, it should be parallel to DF and BC should be equal to DF. So here I have written that BC is parallel to DF and BC is equal to DF. Okay. Now if BC is parallel to DF, then we can say that BC is also parallel to DE, because if the whole sides are parallel, then it will be parallel to the part of this side also, means BC is parallel to DE, and here BC is equal to DF. Okay. So if BC is equal to DF, and DF is what? DF we can write that DE plus EF. Okay. Here I have said that DE and EF are equal. So at the place of EF, we can write DE. Now DE plus DE, it is 2 times DE. And if we find the value of DE from here, then it will be equal to, DE is equal to half of BC. So now we have proved that if we join the two midpoints of the sides of two sides of a triangle, then the side will be parallel to the third side and equal to half of it. Okay. Now students, you can pause the video and note it down, whatever written on the board. Okay. Now students, let us see the converse of midpoint theorem. What is the converse of midpoint theorem? The statement of that is, the line drawn through the midpoint of one side of a triangle parallel to the another side bisects the third side. Okay, means the meaning of this statement is, suppose this is a triangle ABC, this is a triangle ABC, and suppose B is the midpoint of this side AB, then if we draw a line through D, through point D, if we draw a line, suppose we have drawn the line L, okay, we have drawn the line L through point D, okay, and this line is parallel to BC, okay, we have drawn a line L through point D and this line is parallel to BC, then it will bisect the third side, means it will bisect the third side, means the point where this line is intersecting this line, okay, that point should be the midpoint of this third side of the triangle, means we have to prove that F is the midpoint of this this side AC. Okay, so how we will show it, let us see. Firstly, we'll write, to prove this theorem, firstly we'll write that what is given. So here it is given that a triangle ABC in which D is midpoint of AB, okay, and the line L is parallel to the side BC. This line L is parallel to the side BC. Okay, so this information is given, okay, and yes, it is also given that this line L is meeting AC. L is meeting AC at F. Okay, means here this line L intersecting AC at F. Okay, and then we will write in proof part that we have to show that F is midpoint of AC, or you can write that we have to prove that AF is equal to FC. This we have to show. Okay students, so here also, to prove that F is the midpoint of this side AC, we will do the some construction. Okay, and what construction we will do, let us see students, again through point C,
we will draw a line, okay, through point C. We will draw a line such that, suppose we will draw a line through point C such that it intersect this line L at E. Okay, so here this CE is parallel to AB. Okay, so again the same construction we have done here, that through C draw a line drawn CE which is parallel to AB. Okay, so through point C we have drawn a line which is parallel to this side AB. Now students, in the proof part, how we will prove it? So see, this time students, what information we are having? This time we are having the information that this line L is parallel to BC. So if L is parallel to BC, so L is what? We can write that DE also. Okay, so in the proof part, we can write that L is parallel to BC, or we can write that L, at the place of L, line L, we can write that DE is parallel to BC. Okay, this whole side DE is parallel to this side BC. Okay, and since AB is also parallel to CE, by construction AB is parallel to CE, so this we can write that DB is parallel to CE. Okay, if the whole side AB is parallel to CE, so here we can write that this DB is parallel to CE. Now students, you can see that in this quadrilateral, both the pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other. Okay, this side DB is parallel to CE and this side BC is parallel to DE. Means this will imply that quadrilateral DBCE is a parallelogram. Okay, so this quadrilateral DBCE is now a parallelogram. Okay, so if it is a parallelogram, then you can see that the length of this DB, then this will imply that its opposite sides are equal also, means DB is equal to CE. And here it was given that D is the midpoint of AB, means this DB is equal to AD also. So by these two, that DB is equal to CE, means this side is equal to this side, and if this side is equal to this side, means DB is equal to CE, DB is equal to AD. So you can see that AD is equal to CE. You can write that AD, from these two you can write that AD is equal to CE. Okay, suppose it is equation number 1. Okay students, now what else? See, in this time also we will prove that these two triangles are congruent. Okay, so how we can prove that these two triangles are congruent? So see, again this angle, suppose it is angle 1 and this angle is 2. So again angle 1 will be equal to angle 2 because of the same reason as we have done in the last question, that this whole side AB is parallel to CE. So they are the alternate pair of angles. So angle 1 is equal to angle 2. And this angle, suppose it is angle 3 and it is angle 4. So angle 3 is equal to angle 4. So this time students, we can prove it by angle side. Okay, because this time the side is non-included. Okay, so we can prove that these two triangles are congruent by the help of angle side. Okay, so we will write that in triangles, in which two triangles? Triangle AFD and triangle CFE. Okay, in these two triangles, see students, firstly we'll write, we are going to prove it by angle side. So firstly we'll write that angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Reason is what? Reason is vertically opposite angles. Okay? Then we will write that angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Why? Because AB is parallel to CE and alternate interior angles. Because these two sides are parallel to each other and they are the pair of alternate interior angles. So because of that, angle 1 should be equal to angle 2. Okay? And the third one is the side. So we can write that the side AD is equal to the side CE. So now students, and what is the reason behind it? We can write, we have supposed that it is equation number 1. So we can write here directly that from 1. So now you can see students, from angle side, okay, from angle side criterion, triangle AFD is congruent to triangle CFE. Okay, by these two, by the criterion angle side, we can say that these two triangles are congruent to each other. So if they are congruent to each other, then by CPCT we can say that this side AF is equal to FC, because they are the corresponding parts of the congruent triangles, so they will be equal. So if AF is equal to FC, it means that F is the midpoint of the third side, that is AC. Okay, so this is the proof of this theorem, converse of midpoint theorem, where it was given that if a midpoint of one side of a triangle, okay, if a line we have drawn with a midpoint of one side of a triangle, then and that line is parallel to the second line, then it will bisect the third line. Bisect the third line means we have to show that AF is equal to FC. Okay, again we have used the concept of the parallelogram. Okay, we have constructed this CE such that it should be parallel to AB. Then we have shown that this BCED is a parallelogram. Okay, this DBCE is a parallelogram, and after that, if it is a parallelogram, then this side DB is equal to CE, but DB is equal to AD also, so AD is equal to CE. Now in these two triangles, we can see that angle 3 is equal to angle 4, angle 1 is equal to angle 2, and this side is equal to this side, means one non-included side is there. So from angle side, we can say that these two triangles are congruent. So if these two triangles are congruent, then we can say that their corresponding parts should be equal, and if their corresponding parts should be equal, means AF is equal to FC. So now students, you can pause the video and note it down. Now students, coming to our next topic, and the topic is theorem of intercepts. Okay, what is the meaning of intercepts? Firstly, I want to tell you that suppose if two lines are there, okay, if two lines are there and one line is intersecting these two lines, then the part of this line, which you can say that it is a transversal, okay, then the part of this line which is in between these two lines, okay, is known as intercepts. Okay, the part of this transversal line in between these two lines is known as intercepts. So what is the theorem of intercepts? The theorem of intercepts says that if a transversal makes equal intercepts on three or more parallel lines, then any other line cutting them also makes equal intercepts. It means that suppose here three lines are there, you can take more than three also, okay, so here three lines are there, and suppose one transversal is this, okay, one line is P which is intersecting these three lines, and because of the intersection of these three parallel lines, okay, the intercepts are suppose it is A, B and C, the point of intersections are A, B and C, then the intercepts will be what? The intercepts will be AB and BC. So the statement of the theorem is that if three lines are parallel, means suppose L is parallel to M is parallel to N, means three lines are parallel to each other, okay, and one line is there, one line transversal is there, and because of that, whatever the intercepts are formed, that intercepts are equal to each other, means AB is equal to BC. So if it is following in this type of figure, then for any other of the transversal also, their intercepts should be equal. Means suppose here it is the line Q, okay, then its intercepts will also be equal. Means suppose it is D, it is E and it is F, then DE is equal to EF. Okay, means whatever the transversal we will take, okay, the intercepts of that will be equal, okay, as here it was equal. Okay, so this is the concepts of theorem of intercepts. The proof of this is not very important, but yes, we should know the result of this theorem, that if three lines are parallel, one transversal is there, so their intercepts should be equal to each other. So if their intercepts should be equal to each other, then for any other line also which is cutting these three lines, their intercepts should also be equal. Okay, means here DE will be equal to EF. If for a line, for a transversal, intercepts are equal, then for any other line, any other transversal, okay, their intercept should be equal. Okay, the condition, the main condition is that these three lines should be parallel. Okay, students, so you can note down this theorem of intercepts and you can make this figure. Okay, and after that, see, this is enough for today. After that, we will start exercise 8.2. Okay, total five or six questions are there. So in the next part we will solve them questions. Okay, so just note it down. So thank you, students.